Hey guys, I quickly wanted to make a video about what to be aware of for the Christmas season, and I just wanted to start off with a couple points. My first point is to make sure that before you go out to go shopping, that you make a list of the names that you're shopping for, such as, you know, any of these people that might need certain things. You're going to list the items that they need. Just maybe limit yourself to three or four things so that you don't buy too many things for them. So maybe this person doesn't need that many things, you're just going to buy three different things, and once you bought whatever they needed, you can cross them off on your list or check it off, and then that's it. Then you cross their names off and then you're done. You won't have to overspend. So make sure that you take a list with you with the names, and then you cross off the people that you need, that you found, you know, presents for, and that way you're left with a lot more money, and then you know, you have some money to spend for yourself, and make sure that you, if you do buy something for yourself, you know, make a list of what you actually are looking for, because sometimes you can overspend for yourself too. So I'm gonna write here me, and if I needed something, for example, winter jacket, then you can find something, and if, as soon as I would find that, I would cross, you know, my name off, and that's it. Then you know, you either stick to the ones that are left over, you just look to see what else they need, and that's it. So the next point is, just going to erase this. Okay, so the next thing is to set a budget. Set a realistic budget, because you know, if you're going to be buying for more than 6 or 7 people, you may go over the $200 limit. Now just make sure that you check your bank account ahead of time, see if you have, you know, just over budget at least to $500, and then that way you can make sure that you can keep putting money into that account so that you make sure you don't go over your limit. And that way, when you keep buying, you know, the presents that you need, you end up maybe spending only for 60 or something, then, you know, at least you haven't gone over your budget and you're not in debt, as to compared to someone who's in debt for two or 300,000, who knows how many thousands of dollars people spend. But some people are still in debt from the last Christmas, so you don't want to do that. You want to make sure that you're staying within your budget. And if you go over it, I mean, you know, you take responsibility and make sure that you pay your bills. This is something that's very important that people don't normally, you know, think about. They'll think that, oh, I'll probably only spend $200 and that's it. But once you go shopping and you see a lot more deals, you end up spending $300. And then you say, what the heck, you know, I might as well buy these other things because, you know. So make sure that you stick to a budget that is more realistic and something that works for you and your family, and that way you've got everyone crossed off your list. Okay, so the next thing is to check receipts. In this case, I'm going to show you a visual here just because sometimes it's hard to see. This one's from Walmart. And let's just say you bought a bunch of things, just like it shows here. I'm trying to make sure the camera focuses on it. But you make sure that you read through everything, because sometimes they might be duplicated. Like, the items might be duplicated, as to, you can see I bought three different punches or so on. And this one was really cheap anyway. But you make sure that you check at the very bottom here. It's not the debit items. It's where it says change due. It should show zero. So if you see the change due, it should show as $0, because if you're not taking any money out, most of the scams are that some people, it'll show either $20 or $30 showing as you took cash out, but you never actually asked for it. So then it might show up there, even though you never check receipts. Make sure you check that, because that's something that people don't check. And sometimes up here, some people don't check if there's duplicates. See, like up here or down here. Make sure you check if there's duplicates, because you don't want to be paying for the same item twice. So count all your items, and when you get, you know, don't even exit the store. Just take a pen with you and just check them off like that. Check each individual one off to make sure that this is what you bought. And that way you know. So make sure you check all your receipts, especially if they're as big and long as this one. You made a lot of purchases anywhere that you buy. So same as this here. Make sure you check every single thing, especially if it's, you can read it here. Make sure you can read it, and then that way you can check off to make sure everything that you bought. Okay. The next thing is to make sure that you take advantage of Black Friday deals. In that case, if you have three different family members, 1, 2, 3, just like that, and then you find maybe something that is 3 for $10, it saves you money, and that way you can put one of them there so that you don't have as many things to buy for them. Basically, you're crossing things off the list, and then it makes it easier for you. But if you have, for example, 6 for $50, you have to really make sure, do these people need anything from here? If not, don't buy it just because it's on sale. You have to just make sure and think about it before, you know, before you leave, or just check their wish list that you've written on your list. So make sure that you don't overspend. The next thing that people forget to do, most likely in December, and it makes you either, you know, what I'm trying to say is the most thing that people forget to do is pay their bills, because it's a time in December where you're so busy and caught up with all the other shopping and everything and decorating that you forget to pay your necessary bills. So make sure that there is enough left over, or you either pay it ahead of time, or you set a date where you know that this is going to be coming out of your account, and that way you won't have any problems with it. You won't have you know, any overdraft or anything like that. So make sure you pay the bills and you have enough money saved for what is necessary. Okay. I just wanted to show you here another example that it's very common right now, the online scams. There might be websites that you want to, shop certain things or buy certain things from there, and make sure the first thing that when you go that it is a trusted site. So if you have already used it before or other people have used it, they tell you it's a good website, then you can buy from there. And also that you're either able to pay with PayPal or if you're going to use a Visa, it is something that it shows there in a fine print or something that shows that it is a website that accepts Visa and other type of payments. So that way, if you're buying with PayPal, that is a good trusted website and you can purchase things online. And also check the reviews. So make sure that the reviews for the website, it shows that a lot of people have purchased things, they have good reviews. They deliver on time. The product is good and good quality. And in the same time, make sure that before you buy anything online, check the delivery because you may not even get this item on time. You might not even need it because, if it's late, it's late for someone else. You just have to check the delivery time and make sure that it's something that works for you. So make sure you're aware of the online scams and you buy things that you absolutely need. Especially because it's closer to Christmas and everything is probably going to be out of stock. Okay, so that other thing to make sure is don't rush because I know it is a busy time where you got really good deals and you want to make sure you get the deal, but you know what, the item will still be there. If it's not there, then it's sold out, and what are you going to be doing if you're going to be rushing anyway? What's the point? You have to just make sure that you have an item in your mind. If you need to buy this certain pair of shoes, you get there early. And that way they'll still be there. The only other thing is that if they're sold out, you'll just have to check later, and that's about it. But just make sure that you check ahead of time. The other thing is to make sure that you watch your bags, cell phone, and wallets, anything, any belongings, because you might be resting after a bunch of shopping done, and you don't look over it. Someone might be taking your purse or your cell phone if you don't look. And you're gonna be left with some kind of sadness and depression over the Christmas season just because someone took something that really belonged to you. And mainly just make sure you watch your kids because they tend to run around. You don't want to have any problems or any more stress added to it. So if you have to go out and shop, make sure you do it when the kids are either asleep. Or make sure you don't take them with you, or you can leave them at the daycare where there's some place that someone's looking over them and you won't have that extra stress. And also make sure that if you are shopping around, since you're rushing and everything, to make sure that you don't sign up on any kind of there's some people that usually they get to just sign up on certain things, and for example, like world, I don't know, worldwide, or I'm not exactly sure what other, charity kind of thing you're gonna sign up on, and they end up taking money out of your account if you don't look over it and if you don't track it every day. And that way it makes you go over debt. So make sure you don't sign up on anything while you're doing all this Christmas shopping, because you won't really be listening to them. You just kind of say, yeah, take my credit card, here you go. And then later on, you're going to be stuck with a bill that you can't pay. And it's really not worth it. So try not to sign up for anything. So basically, the way to, avoid overspending, is to make sure you ask yourself the questions that you need to be asked for exactly that specific item. Do you really need it? And how badly do you need it? Is it something that, you can't live without? Is it something that you absolutely need it right away? And again, is it worth it? Is it worth the money? Is it worth, maybe some other store will have it? And also, are you able to buy it later or buy something else instead of it? Maybe there is another store that has a different version of this item that might be less, or they might have it again some other time, and you can just buy it a little bit later so that you don't keep overspending on things that you see right away. Instead, you can wait it out, and maybe during Boxing Day or any other day, you can come back and see, oh, that was the present I wanted to get, so I can get it cheaper. The other thing is that this helps me a lot is to wait 7 days, and if you can't stop thinking about that item or that pair of shoes or whatever it is, then you can buy it. But if you've thought about it throughout the whole week, give it at least a week and see if you still are stressing about it, still thinking about it. If you really, really want it, then that's a good time to get it, and then you know for sure that's something that you really need. If you in the 7 days, if you've seen something better, you might even get a different kind of shoes or something else, and that way you know for sure that it's something that you don't even need to worry about. So the other thing is just to make sure that if you have any unused clothing or toys or anything that you don't need anymore, maybe there's some toys that your kid is not currently playing with them anymore, or they grew up and they won't use them anymore. Donate them and make sure that you donate either to the homeless or any local kids hospital charities that you can think of, and you can look in your neighborhood area in the community website. There must be something that you can donate to. And again, thank you for watching, and give it a thumbs up if you liked it. That's my little hand drawing there. So thank you again for watching. I hope these tips were really helpful for you. And as usual, I'll see you again when I make another video. Thank you again for watching. Yeah, I just wanted to show you real quick that I got a deal on these cute little slippers. They were 3 for $10, and I crossed my mom's name off that list, that she needed some slippers and I needed some slippers. And the extra pair, I can probably give it to a friend, but I just couldn't resist. So I had to buy these cute little slippers. And there's another pair here that I really like. These ones I really liked as well. They have cute little pom-poms. And then I got another pair that I might give to my friend. So he was in this bag here. And these cute little pair. He has cute little stars on them and a bow right here. I thought this was really cute and a great idea. So if you find any good ideas, good deals, link them. Hopefully there's any good deals in your area. I also got these cute pairs of shoes. They're high heel and they're Uggs, like almost like Uggs. Not the same brand, just a bit cheaper though. But they're really nice and they fit. So I thought, since I have these, I also have a black pair that I bought before and I really loved it. So these are the black pair. So yeah, this is what I got on my deals. I'm probably gonna be buying a couple more things, and my names are almost done off the list. Thanks again for watching.